It may have pristine bodywork, but Drew and Paul's Cortina GT has given them a major mechanical headache. For two decades, the humble Ford Cortina was a staple of British motoring life, spending 10 years as the nation's best-selling car. With its clean, modern lines, the Mark II was introduced in 1966 and included an uprated GT model. But thanks to a familiar enemy, the once ubiquitous Cortina has become a rare sight.
That's an X engine.
But Drew wants to capitalize on the situation by fitting a more powerful motor, and he's driven all the way to Kent to visit a very special company.
So we're down in Maidstone and we're off to see some lads who I've seen on YouTube and all of those channels because they build the hottest engine for Ford Escorts and all of the Ford derivatives in Britain, if not the world.
The name Harris has been associated with fast Fords since the 1950s, when engines built by Ron Harris began tearing up Britain's racetracks and drag strips. And today, that engine tuning knowledge and skill has been passed down to Ron's son, Jeff, and grandson, James.
How's it going?
James.
Nice to meet you.
You've got to tell me about this.
This is my dad's car, standard car when he got it.
What is it now?
It's a just over 2 litre Pinto engine, 170 horsepower, roughly.
So I pull up to Harris Performance Engineering, and there's Mark II Escort 1300 gear. You can guarantee it's not standard. Blimey.
Wolf in sheep's clothing.
Yeah. What a piece of kit.
From their dedicated workshop, Harris build engines for Ford fanatics around the world.
Oh, yes. This is my idea of heaven.
And each engine is hand-built to suit its customers' needs.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, this one's actually 187 horsepower going in a circuit car. You don't need anything like that in a, you know, you want a mildly modified engine.
There's one engine in there that's on a stand that's finished, which is exactly the same as our engine. And instantly I'm like, I'm having that. I want that one. It is beautiful. Engines can be beautiful, can't they?
Yes, definitely.
Even if you're not into engines, you know, you have to appreciate the beauty of the mechanical work that they're doing to these things, and the finish, the attention to detail, is just mind-blowing. That's why we're here. I love guys like this.
Harris's entry-level engine is £3,500 and will give the Cortina a significant boost in power. But Drew wants to add some optional extras.
I want this. Definitely, that is a thing of beauty. Can I have twin carbs on it as well?
Yeah, absolutely. It's got to make the right noises.
Yeah. And the trumpets.
Yep.
With the mesh on.
Yeah, not a problem.
So that is beautiful. Well, what we're doing here, we're buying two things. We're buying a hot new engine, because, well, we need one, but we're also buying all of those decades of Harris reliability and speed and craftsmanship. And that, whatever the engine costs, will add more to this car, a lot more, and make it really desirable.
Brilliant.
Obviously, I need it yesterday.
Of course, we'll do our best.
All right,
I'll
mate,
work some late nights.
We'll be in touch.
Right, lovely. Mate, cheers, Drew. See you later.
Work starts with a second-hand engine block, and using an electric wire brush and needle gun, Jeff painstakingly removes any old paint or surface rust. And once the block's been given a fresh coat of tough, heat-resistant paint, the build can begin.
I'm now going to fit the crankshaft. I'll now drop that into place. All threads have been cleaned up, so it's nice and easy to screw these in by hand.
James and Jeff handpick each internal component to suit whatever engine they're building.
And quite often, we try different things on our own cars and in our own engines to come up with, you know, what is basically a recipe that every single component works together.
But precision is also vital, so James must ensure that components like the pistons connecting rods are evenly weighted to minimise vibration.
To get, obviously, all the big ends weighing the same, we would start taking material off of there. And we try and stay away from the sides, but if really necessary, you know, we can take some of that flashing off as well.
At the workshop, the rest of the car is being readied for the new motor. With new seals in place, the car's now watertight, and it's been fitted with a fresh set of wheels.
Michael has worked his magic on the dashboard, carefully filling and sanding all the cracks that were hidden by the padded cover.
It should be a vast improvement from what we had there before.
And after many hours of meticulous assembly in Maidstone, the new engine is ready to be fired up.
It doesn't get any less nerve-wracking from the first time I ever done it to the last time, but that's the whole point of the rig, so that you can check everything is 100%. Yeah, happy with that.
A few days later, and the new motor is ready to be dropped into place.
All right, a bit more.
And the car is soon ready for an outing. Paul's asked Drew to meet him at Kerberos Sprint Circuit in Staffordshire, where a track day for classic Fords is in full swing.
Come on in, Cowland. Where's my Ford? Oh, yes. Look at that.
It sounds amazing.
Mate, perfection. I hear it start up, comes around the corner, bang on, superb.
You ready?
Yeah. Oh, look at that. Wow.
That's superb.
What a thing.
It's so beautiful, isn't it?
It is a thing of beauty. Oh, my favourite.
Yeah.
Grills on the trumpets.
I know.
Love those. The engine is superb. It cannot fault the engine at all. The Harris lads did a perfect job. I'm over the moon with it.
Now, the dash, as you know...
Had it, yeah.
Yeah, not very nice. And that now is really rather nice.
Is that the original?
Yeah, it's been repaired. Managed to save that.
Wow.
But the
so
season...
we haven't spent any money on the interior?
No. Do you want to know what we've spent?
I'm dreading it, really.
No, actually, you'd be surprised. So £6,000 for the car, with the engine, the wheels, tickle the dashboard and the seals, just over £6,000. And I think the car will make, to the right person, and the sun's come out.
14?
14. 13,995.
We all buy cars that say something about us or that do something for us when we drive them. When that engine went bang, I thought, right, I get my chance to do what I want to do, which is put a hot engine in a Ford. When do I get a chance to make it go sideways?
You get to drive it now, you do not make it go sideways, but you can tickle it round like the old man that you've dressed as.
Thank you.
Gently, bearing in mind this is a brand new engine.
It's just white noise now, you know that, don't you?
Just look after it, please. I could just listen to that engine sound all day.
Just that roar. Do you know what I love about this car?
Go on.
Is I'm driving along thinking, ooh, I could do that to it, and ooh, I could do this to it. And that's the lovely thing about them. It's not like restoring an old 911 or a Rolls-Royce or a Jag or something like that that costs fortunes.
No, it's true, isn't it? It's always been the blue-collar man's car, isn't it? That's the great thing about an old Ford.
Great fun to drive this.
Yeah, I bet it is.
It's a great little car.
So, as you haven't broken it, should we just get back to the paddock and see if we can get somebody excited about it?
There's a lot of lads here with some very nice Fords.
You know, the first thing I'm going to do is pop the bonnet, show off my Harris.
Sold.
With plenty of other Mark II Cortinas on show, including a rare Lotus version, Drew and Paul's car is in exalted company.
There you go.
Feel free to have a look around.
Yeah, have a look around, though. It's a warm crowd, isn't it, to be fair? But what's really nice is just chatting to some of the guys. The things we've done, they seem to like.
It looks good.
Yeah,
really
thank you.
I'm impressed with what you've done there.
I do feel vindicated, and all these guys here appreciate it. They're good. Yep, like it, great, great fun. We do exactly that.
So I think we're about in the right place.
I'm happy.
Yeah,
I'm very happy with it. Lovely job. Next one.
Yes.